First and foremost, the interviewer is looking to find someone who they know is passionate about the subject that they would like to study. They will be spending a lot of private time with you over the next 3 to 4 years in individual tutorials or in groups of 2 or 3. So they'd like to know that you're really going to contribute to their own academic stimulation over that period of time. They also need to like you. That's almost as important. I think, on top of that, the other thing they'd like to see in an interview setting is that you can show your workings. They'd like to see that you can think your way through a problem rather than just resolving it in your head and giving them an answer. It's fine in an interview to ask for prompts, ask for help. They'd like to see that you're willing to accept the support when trying to solve a problem, and that you can show your working and ultimately get the right answer rather than knowing it straight away at the beginning of the question.
One of the biggest qualities I would say that interviewers are looking for is an intellectual curiosity. So they want someone who is keen to learn more, to push beyond the boundaries of their existing knowledge, and really to take on new information and relish those opportunities to learn, because they know that coming into the interview you won't have all of the answers, but they want to see that you have the potential to reach those answers with their support.
The biggest weakness we feel students come into the course with is that they haven't really been put through their paces by somebody that they feel intimidated by or slightly uncomfortable giving answers to. They will have asked family members and friends to ask them, give them more confused, ask them more confused questions, which is brilliant and something they should definitely be doing. But to be in an environment where they're around people who are asking questions, who've been through that course previously, gives a certain extra edge to it, which I think gives a much better version of preparation. That means come interview day, they'll be much better prepared.
Our courses are led by our team of consultants who have either graduated from or are still studying in the student's chosen field of study. So that means they have a really strong understanding of the admissions process, the interviews, the sort of questions you could be asked and how to prepare for them, and they have a wealth of tips that they will pass on to help support your application.
The afternoon session of 3 interviews is broken up into 2 interviews with someone who has graduated your chosen subject, and the third one, a more general tutor who studied something different. In doing so, the first 2 interviews can be very technically focused, so asking questions that are very specific to your chosen area. And the third interview can then be more general questions that I think a lot of students maybe don't prepare that well for, because they see them as relatively simple answers to give. But until you've actually practiced them, it can be very different on the day. So we feel that by preparing students in the morning for seminars, you then have 2 interviews where the first one you may be quite nervous for, the second one you're much better prepared for and you feel you give a better version of yourself, and the final one you can then attack very, very confidently and feel that you've left the day with a confident perspective of how you will approach interview day.